I'm ready.
Fantastic.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
Please welcome to the stage, Brian Lothbrock. I take cash and checks just in case anyone's wondering. Life can be funny, life can be true. Why are you dressed as a prisoner? Well, I'll tell you, the simple reason is obviously clear. I've had 12 shit years while I've been here. I've tried the BBC, it's true. I've tried TV stations too. They don't want real poor, literally. They want a middle-class wanker reciting honesty. But as a poet, I've got to say, I challenge the BBC, all of them, all the intellectual ones in the modern day. I said, you can recite your poetry, and I'll know a better one instantaneously. But they won't respond to me, because I'm a poor, poor, and honest, you see. I won't kiss ass, what can I say? But if I was on TV, I wouldn't swear much anyway. The simple reason, to be honest and true, I'd be after the cash, but wouldn't you too? Money matters in this life, I say, so get rid of most of the MPs or the House of Lords, and we'll be okay. There's 800 of the old gets, allegedly, in the House of Lords, in honesty. Why are we got 800 old gets waiting to die? And we're giving them cash, and they're getting high. Well, I think we should get rid of most of them, it's true. 400 would be a fair number, and get rid of the rest, that's what I would do. And I'd only vote one in, literally, when one dies, in honesty. We're paying too many middle-class wankers for me to sit on their ass in the House of Lords, you see. But then it comes to common sense, I've got to say, why don't we just stop for, say, 5 years, give them foreign aid and money away? That'll solve our money problem straight away. And we can build a better metro, even go to Hartlepool. Hey, what do you say? And I would have it nice and true, with good lights and cameras too. So the morons know, you know what they say, they can't mug you, they'll be on camera straight away. And then people could travel safe and true all around the northeast like we really want to. But as a poor port, I do like the wind, it's true. But if you want a real port, just ask me, that's what I do. And that's a natural, I've got to say. It's very embarrassing. I can't see it in the back anyway. Anyway, what's your name though? What is it?
Frankie.
Frankie is kind, Frankie is true. Watch out for men like me, that's what I say to you. Because as a man, I'm not going to say, I might be a port, but I'm a randy one anyway. I've had many women in my life, it's true. Yes, for relationships, I haven't a clue. Why would I want a relationship at my age, literally? I'm 53, not 23. I'm happy on my own, I've got to say. I don't watch Coronationenders or EastEnders or any of that crap anyway. I don't watch every day, that's true. And if a woman come in the house, I'd have to watch it like you. So as a poor, literally, I'm not going to watch that shit on TV. I don't want to watch it, it's true. And I've never met a woman worth it too. But that's me, what can I say? I can tell a good woman in the honest way. I call them sister-in-laws, literally. I've got two people in touch with sister-in-laws. Hey, you've never been lucky, there's never going to be three. But two on the 3 year ban, it's true. Two good women in the family, that's two! Not that way, you know what they say. That's what I do with women when they want a relationship, by the way. I'm not a settling down kind, it's true. If she had a good job, I'd settle down and be a house husband too. I've a clean house, literally, in half an hour, they just sit and watch TV. You've got a washing machine, what can I say? Them take it on for a day, clean the house, by the way. They come out with so much shit in the modern day. But that's men and all, by the way. But on a good day, I've got to say, I like a good laugh, and I'd like to be on telly one day, because I'm not camera shy, as you can see. I don't give a, but that is me. But as an old poet, you've got to try to make people laugh, it's true, because that's exactly what I want to do. It feels so good when you've done it, it's true. It's the best performing art you can ever do. But I'd like to say I memorise and categorise and analyse, it's not true. I just make it up as I go along, that's what real poetry do. But you get the boffins, you know what they say? They won't help me in the modern day. I've tried them all, literally, and they say, fill this form and tell me what you want to do in honesty. I want to fuck off from Hartlepool, you see. And I like a cameraman, and I do poetry, just for a laugh in honesty. But they wouldn't give me the 87 grand, what could I do? So I'll apply again this time, ask for 7, well, wouldn't you? I won't get it, you know what they say. But if you don't ask, you don't get it in the modern day. And then I went to the Ark and stopped, and it's true. I said, can you help a poor port like me to do what I want to do? And I wouldn't swear on there, truly, it's true. Because it was a bit of a posh place, they don't like swearing, what can you do? So they're being polite, literally. And I went there, got an interview in all honesty. I got on with the university types, it's true, and I give them a bit of wisdom, a bit of common sense too. And they loved me poorly, literally. Then I got an email back saying basically, fuck off me. But they put it politely, I've got to say, they said find a pub. So every first Wednesday of every month, I'm going to be next door in the Storytellers doing what I say. Doing live performance poetry, I want to make it the biggest in the UK, and honestly, I want to shove that up their rich arseholes, it's true. And I don't care if they're academics, they're wankers, thank you. So all the best with me to thee. And just because you're academic, if you're watching this on TV, I've got to say, it doesn't make it right and true, it just means you remember shit, so fuck you too. It's a long time since I had a woman say that to me. I looked down and I said, look at Peter, what have you got, 5.5 inches? I can't give you any more. I like a laughing life, it's true. A laughter's good for endorphins too. It makes you happy, you know what they say. It makes you naturally happy, and it's not a drug, by the way. The simple reason, I know it's true, the government can't charge you for it too. One day they'll try, you know what they say. Hey, you're meant to be miserable, you poet. Why aren't you miserable, you're laughing anyway? But they do their best, literally. The Conservatives really fuck you over, in all honesty. And they've done a good job of it, it's true. But you vote them in. I never did do. I'm not that stupid, what can I say? I know what I'd like to say to them if I saw them one day, especially if I had a pint or two. I'd want to smash them in the nose. I think it'd be worth an 8 quid fine too. But as a good man, literally, I wouldn't smash him in the nose. I'd stand on his toe on purpose and on purpose, really. Because it hurts more than a broken nose, it's true. And you can say it was an accident too. But when you look at life, I've got to say, when I'm dead, I went a fortune, by the way. It's not my fault the humans aren't sharp enough, literally, to get me on TV and have a good laughing, honestly. But if they paid me, you know what they say? I stop fucking swearing straight away. Give me the cash, what can I say? I'd be a flight port, I wouldn't be gay. I've got nothing against gays, it's true. I like lesbians. I like 2 women at a time if you can do. I'm only kidding, literally. I'm a man for 1 woman, and 1 woman is enough for me. I like a woman for sex, it's true. I don't like her for cooking or ironing, because I don't do. I've got a slow cooker, what can I say? The last girl went, I got rid of it. I went to Argos and got another slow cooker straight away. That one was 20 quid, literally. But it never, ever argued with me. When I was pissed, what can I say? I think I had some intelligent conversations with that slow cooker. That's one of the ex-girlfriend, by the way. Anyway, thank you, have a good night. Thank you for coming to Newcastle.